Would you like to know how to reduce complicated expressions into smaller, simpler pieces? In this video, you will learn about the concept of composition, which will help you to break up those complicated expressions in manageable pieces. In order to have a large library of functions to use in modeling real-world phenomena, we need more than just the basic functions we have been telling you about. You can combine polynomials and signs by, for example, adding them or multiplying them. One of the more complicated ways to combine two functions is to compose them. The most tricky rule of differentiation, the chain rule, deals with composed functions, as you will see in week 5. If you consider a function to be a machine with inputs on the left and outputs on the right, a composed function is akin to an assembly line. We take two functions, let us say sine and square, and put them in a line. Moving the input x first through the sine, the intermediate outcome is sine of x. Then, moving this through the square function, we end up with sine of x squared. Together, they form a new function, the composition of x squared, the rightmost function, with sine x, the leftmost function. If we had put the boxes in opposite order, we would have obtained x goes to x squared goes to sine of x squared, which is the composition of sine x with x squared. Notice that these two expressions are not equal. If we plug in x equals 1, we obtain either sine of 1 squared is approximately 0.71, or sine of 1 is approximately 0.84. The order of operations matter. Of course, this is true of a real assembly line as well. A cookie manufacturing line first mixes the ingredients and then puts them in the oven. If it were to first put the ingredients in the oven and then mixes the results, you would not buy the resulting cookies. If you have two functions f and g, their composition is written as f of g of x. So the first function on the assembly line is placed inside the last function. The order in which you apply the functions is important. I can't repeat this often enough. So if you have a composed function, you want to explicitly realize what the inner and outer functions are. I like to designate the inner function by putting a box around it like so. This way, I can quickly see the structure of my complicated function. This concept of composition is useful because it allows you to turn complicated problems into multiple simpler ones. As an example, consider the equation x to the 8th plus 2x to the 4th plus 1 equals 4. There is no quadratic formula for the degree 8 equations. However, we can see x to the 8th plus 2x to the 4th plus 1 as the composition of f of x equals x squared plus 2x plus 1 with g of x equals x to the 4th. Thus, we first solve f of p equals 4, which gives p squared plus 2p plus 1 equals 4. So, p equals minus 3, or p equals 1. Hence, f of g of x equals 4 whenever g of x equals minus 3, or g of x equals 1. Now, we solve the latter two equations, x to the 4th equals minus 3, and x to the 4th equals 1. The first has no solutions, and the second has solutions x equals 1 and x equals minus 1. Thus, these are the only two solutions to the complicated equation x to the 8th plus 2x to the 4th plus 1 equals 4. Now, try to figure out how you can explicitly see the complicated functions from the exercises as compositions.